His birthday, they may not understand. Jesus, Mekaniah, I worship you today. Jesus, Mekaniah, I bow before your throne. Jesus, Mekaniah, I worship you today. Hi, everybody. Good evening. Welcome to Behind the Veil, a series we'll be having every Saturday evening into midnight to Sunday morning, and to take us into the place where we have an intimacy with the Father before the new week begins. We all know that Sunday is the very first day of the month of, Sunday, the very first day of every week. And so we want to have an opportunity to spend maybe 30 minutes with the Lord before the new week. Praise the Lord. You're all welcome. Yes, happy to see you, Helen. You're welcome. Ekom, thanks for joining. We just want to have a little brief time with God, and that's like 30 minutes, and then we pray together so that we know that by the time the month, the new week starts, we are already set in the presence of God. So I'm happy to have us here at such short notice. Quickly, let's just bless the name of God. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this brief moment we are having in your presence. And we ask that your glory will saturate this place, that your presence will fill this place, that you will reveal your counsel in our life and in the life of everyone that is watching tonight, those that are watching via Facebook and those that are watching via Instagram. Father, we give you glory and praise in the name of Jesus. So today we want to look at a very powerful secret for the rest, divine rest in all that we do. As we enter into a new week, I hear the Spirit of the Lord say that it shall be a week of rest on every side. No stress whatsoever, no issues whatsoever, no harassment whatsoever. It shall be rest on every side in the name of Jesus. And quickly, we're going to look at Exodus chapter 33. Verse 13 and 14. I'll try to be as fast as possible. Exodus 33, verse 13 and 14. And Moses was praying to the Lord that he needed grace and favor. The scripture says, "Now therefore I pray thee, if I have found grace in thy sight, show me now thy way, that I may know thee. If I have found grace in thy sight, show me now thy way, that I may know thee, and that I may find grace in thy sight, and consider that this nation is thy people." And God spoke to him and said, "My presence shall go with thee, and I will give thee rest. My presence shall go with thee, and I will give thee rest." And Moses went on to say, "If thy presence does not go with me, do not carry me from here. For how will they know that I and thy people have found grace in thy sight?" And the Lord said, "I will do this thing." God spoke to Moses and he told him, he said, "My presence will go with you and I will give you rest." Child of God, if you are going to experience rest on every side, what you need is the presence of God. Now, quickly, what does rest on every side mean? And I'm going to mention maybe about three today. The things I want you to expect to see in your life in the new week we are entering, beginning from tomorrow. What is rest on every side? What is that rest that God is promising us? Number one, rest means relief from stress. Rest means relief from stress. It means there is no stress, nothing to make you sweat, nothing to make you bothered, nothing to disturb your life. God says, "My presence will go with you and you will be relieved from stress." I declare upon your life that in the new week we are entering, there shall be no stress whatsoever in the name of Jesus. Whatever cost you stress, whatever cost you embarrassment, shall be taken care of in the name of Jesus. It shall be taken care of. So everything that people had to struggle, had to stress themselves to achieve, you will get it cheaply in the name of Jesus. That's my prayer for you, that whatsoever it is that people struggle to get, they struggle to achieve, as you enter this new week, you will get it cheaply in the name of Jesus. That's the promise of God for us, that there shall be peace, there shall be rest on every side. Now, the second thing, what is the meaning of rest? Rest means rescue from troubles. That means that when God gives you rest, there shall be no trouble whatsoever. Rest means rescue from troubles. Troubles, you know, there are many people that have wars on every side, crisis on every side, troubles on every side. They wake up in the morning, wahala. They go out, wahala, headache. A call from the village, call from mommy, call from daddy, call from husband, call from wife, call from relative. Oh, fire on the mountain. Today, I declare that as you go into the new week, every fire on the mountain is over forever in your life in the name of Jesus. That's the promise of the Father to us. He said, I will give you rest. I will give you rest. That means he's saying, I will give you rest from troubles. There shall be no troubles in the name of Jesus. So whatever troubles are around you, the Bible says 1,000 may fall at your side, 10,000 at your right side. It says it shall not come near you. I'm speaking into your life, you that is listening to me right now. I declare and I decree that there shall be rest on every side. Whatever gave people troubles shall not give you trouble in the name of Jesus. Receive rest on every side. Be free from troubles in the name of Jesus. If there was any trouble cooked around that the enemy has been cooking for you, that trouble is over forever in the name of Jesus. The last one we're going to look at today, the meaning of rest, is relief from burdens. Relief from burdens. I love this one. I love this one because I know that a whole lot of people have been struggling, have been suffering from burdens, financial burdens, emotional burdens, marital burdens, and all sorts of burdens. But hear me, the Bible says, Jesus was speaking, he said, come unto me, all ye that are laden and are heavy burdened. He said, I will give you rest. I will give you rest. So when God says, I will give you rest, it means that I will take away the burden from your shoulder. And somebody listening to me today, somebody watching this or watching the replay, I'm speaking into your life today that everything that has been before now a burden has been lifted from your shoulder in the mighty name of Jesus. That burden financially, there is someone here, you are wondering, how am I going to make ends meet? I don't know where I'm going to get money again. Business is not working the way it should have worked. Things are not happening. Ends are not meeting. Listen to me. Those ends may not meet, but Jesus is going to make a way for you. Every financial burden is over forever in the name of Jesus. I see God miraculously provide your every need according to his riches in glory through Christ Jesus, in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. So financial rest, emotional burden. Emotional burden that has been there, you've been bothered. Every other person goes to sleep, but you turn up and down on your bed because you are burdened, heavily burdened. Today I speak peace to you. That thing that used to stress you, make you lie down on the bed, you turn to and fro, it is over forever in the name of Jesus, because God says, I give you rest. I give you rest. So every burden is over forever in the name of Jesus. Before we pray finally today, I want to speak, I want to declare one, I want to mention one key to this rest that we are talking about. This life free from troubles, this life free from stress, this life free from burdens. What is the key? That scripture, it says, my presence shall go with you and great shall be your peace. It says, my presence shall go with you and I will give you rest. So the major secret for this rest that God is talking about is his presence. His presence. So child of God, as we go into the new week, I want you to go with the presence of God. I want you to go with the presence of God. Don't make up your mind that every day in this new week we are entering, you will not jump out of your bed and go out. You will spend at least a few moments to pray, to worship, play worship music. Just feel yourself, charge yourself with the presence of God before you leave your house, and you will see his blessings, you will see his favor, you will see his rest, you will see him answering questions for you, you will see him stepping and intervening on your behalf in the name of Jesus. You need the presence of God. You need to carry the tangible presence wherever you are. And someone here, you've been For a while now, you've not experienced the presence of God like you used to. I hear by the Spirit of God, there is someone here. You used to experience the presence of God before, but all of a sudden, you don't know what is happening. You may try to sing, you may try to pray, but you are not just connecting. I pray for you a connection in the name of Jesus. Connect again. It will be easy for you to connect with the presence of God in the name of Jesus. It'll be easy again. It says, he that hungers and thirsts shall be filled. So for everyone that will hunger for the presence of God, that will desire the presence of God, that will thirst for the presence of God, as you leave this place tonight to go to bed, by the time you wake up in the morning, you will see an ease of worship, an ease of praise, an ease of that presence covering you, hovering around you in the name of Jesus. I declare peace on every side. Now, somebody lift up your voice and begin to worship the Lord and thank him for the word he has sent to us today. Give him the glory, give him the praise for this word that has come briefly yet powerfully. I want you to thank him in advance for the things he will do. Whatever it is you've been expecting God to do, I want you to type it there in the comments and say, Lord, thank you for finances shall be awesome this week. As I enter the new week, I want you to type it there in the comment section. I want you to say, Father, thank you. Thank you for good health. If you were sick in your body, I want you to thank him in advance for the good health. If you did not experience the presence of God before now, I want you to type there in the comment and thank God for a new level in his presence because he has done it. Somebody join me as we lift up our voice in 1 minute and give God thanks for the words and the promises that he has given to us today. Lift up your voice, give him praise, give him glory, give him all the honor, give him all the adoration, just reverence him. And Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for everyone watching right now. I declare rest on every side in the name of Jesus. Everyone watching, those that will be watching the replay, I declare peace and rest on every side in their lives in the name of Jesus. Now, before I pray the final prayer, you are here and you've not given your life to Christ. I want to pray for you a prayer of salvation because whom the Son of Man has set free is free indeed. Unless you receive Jesus into your life, you may not and you will not enjoy the rest we are talking about. This rest we are talking about is only for those that will give their lives to Christ and will live a life for Jesus. So right now, I want to pray for you. If you are going to give your life to Christ right now, it has to be done now. You don't know tomorrow. You don't know when Jesus is coming. He may come any moment. The Bible says any moment, any hour, he may come in a twinkling of an eye. So you want to be ready for that life with God. You want to be ready to live a fruitful life here on earth even before Jesus comes. So say after me, Lord Jesus, come into my life. I repent of all my sins. I repent of everything I have done that is not of you. Have mercy on me. Say, Father, today I receive Jesus into my life. Take over my life. Rule in my life and reign in my life. Father, this I pray in the name of Jesus. It's as simple as that. The Bible says that when you receive Jesus, when you confess Jesus with your mouth that he's Lord and believe him in your heart, he is yours. So I'm happy that you have confessed him today. I'm happy that you've opened up your mind to him today. And I'll pray for you right now. Father, I pray for everyone that said that prayer with me. I ask for a new life. I pray for a new dimension. I pray against troubles and crisis in the name of Jesus. I speak peace into their lives. And I ask, oh God, for a new thing that you have begun in their life to be perfected and actualized in the name of Jesus. Your life is new. You are changed. There is nobody, no accusation whatsoever that can hold you bound in the name of Jesus. Right now, let me pray for you. Somebody in this place that is sick in their body, I declare healing in your life from the crown of your head to the sole of your feet in the name of Jesus. I come against that devil that has been battling with your life, that has been struggling with that belongs to you. Right now, I command you, devil, let go and lose God's people in the name of Jesus. I speak into your life. I speak favor. I speak abundance. This week we are entering into shall be a week of blessings, shall be a week of testimonies, shall be a week of favor. I speak into your life that favor all round shall be your portion in the name of Jesus. Most of all, we claim the word that God has spoken to us today. peace on every side, rest on every side. No more struggle, no more troubles, no more burdens in the name of Jesus. And I thank you, Father, because I know it is done. I give you praise because you always hear me. For in Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen and amen. I know you have been blessed. I can see your comments. I can see your amens. I can see your hallelujahs. I want you to share this video. And every Saturday night into Sunday morning, we're going to be meeting like this for just 30 minutes to declare into our new week. So keep posted, stay tuned for next Saturday at about 10 p.m., 11 p.m., 12 a.m., one of those between that time. But I'll bring out a flyer that will talk about it before Saturday so that you know the exact time I'll be live. We'll just hold hands together. We'll pray and believe God for a fruitful week ahead. I can't wait to hear your testimonies. And I pray for you that everything you have asked God for in this program today, you receive it in the name of Jesus. Go forth and live a victorious life. You are blessed and you are favored. Hallelujah. I'm so excited for those of us that joined me live. Helen, I can see you. Thanks for joining. I can see, I can see Ruth. I can see a whole lot of you. Thank you for joining. Please share this video so that some other people can receive the blessings. And we will do this again next Saturday. Thank you. Have a wonderful day. And see you in church tomorrow. For those that gave their life to Christ, look for a Bible-believing church and go and attend and see what the Lord will do. If you are in the city of Uyo, I'm inviting you to Precious Faith International Church. It's in number 27B Acre Street. Acre Street is off Ikodekbene Road, off Wellington Bassey Way. You cannot miss it. Once you get in there, you can't miss the building. You can't miss the premises. So I invite you to church tomorrow morning, 8 a.m. For those that are not in the city of Uyo, go to a sister church, a good church, a believing church, wherever you are, a Bible-believing church, and make sure you are in church tomorrow morning. None of you should miss service tomorrow. Make sure you are in church, and let's be victorious throughout the new week. I wait to hear your testimonies. When something happens, when you have a testimony, make sure you come back to this video and comment and share your testimony. And the Lord bless you in the name of Jesus. Do have a wonderful night, and we'll see you again next Saturday. Bye-bye. God bless you. Have a wonderful day, and the Lord bless you. Okay, thanks. I'm happy to see you, Ogechi. God bless you.
Be faithful in all your ways. Your name is powerful than any force in this world. Yeah. You are glorious and faithful in